Just a question. Why do so many players on Europe server last pick Vivian after the team already has a damage, a flanker, and a support, and an off tank? Why do you pick Vivian? Why are you last picking Vivian? Are you thinking that you're gonna carry the match? Well, obviously you're not. You just threw the match. But it's really common right now. It's really common. What's sad is they're also playing Opportunity and Chaos. Now, I've already had a video where I've explained exactly what this does, which is at close range, in its effective range, your weapon will only need one less bullet to kill the enemy while this is in effect. I've already demonstrated that. You might want to go check that out in the TTK video. Now, let's just go ahead and do it at range. I'm just going to show you the numbers before showing you that in action. So basically, at this range, which is 140 units between me and that Victor over there, not running Opportunity in Chaos due to falloff, it's going to take me 21 bullets to kill him over 2.94 seconds. If I was running Opportunity in Chaos and I start shooting him after the first 2 seconds, you know, when the talent actually activates and gives me that 10%, it's only gonna save me 5 bullets. Okay, so yeah, it's good, right? No, it's not good. It requires you to shoot 15 bullets before you get the effect. Okay? And that's that. Let's just show you how that looks like.
Rampage!
Let me go ahead and show you the two viable ways to play Vivian. And yes, I am saying this is viable. I'll explain it later. First off, booby trap. Now, the loadout that I'm using is Muru's one. It's really perfect. It does not miss anything. Okay, basically what this does, it allows you to get someone out of cover or poke them from safety. Okay, so basically the cracks on Split Stone Quarry, you can just drop your mine and do damage with it between the cracks. Okay, that's how you use this. I've got to explain the loadout so that you'd know what you're doing. And yes, I understand, Vivian's skill ceiling is at the floor. It's not up. It's way too low. All that you're supposed to be doing in this loadout is you use precision sights, which I know Vivian doesn't need it. I know, don't tell me. But this gives you resets, okay, cooldown resets on your drones, which are 600 damage each, okay? And you've got the movement speed. You really need this at all times. If you stop shooting, you can escape from anything if you need to escape, but escaping isn't something that you want to do. Okay, you're supposed to be putting pressure on the enemy as Vivian. You've got some extra health, and the extra reveal time is really good. These two are fillers. You can put wherever you want to put instead of these two. Now, basically, let me just show you how fast you can get your sensors back.
I have eyes everywhere.
15 in a row! So
well, so you kill someone before you do get them back, but still, it's really good to have it. Really good to have it. So you've gotta be aiming and shooting someone. You can't just aim and shoot. You gotta hit something. And that's how you play booby trap on Vivian. Let me introduce you to suspect everyone. What this talent does is make your shields even more broken, really. Let me explain why this is good, actually. Well, simple enough. Your time to kill is 1.8 seconds on a 2200 squishy. Okay, if their health is a little bit higher, you're just gonna add a little bit more of time. Okay, you deal 170 damage every 0.14 seconds, meaning that if they've buffed their health to 2450, that's almost 2 seconds. It's a little bit more, but still, it's almost 2 seconds to kill them. If they're using DR, then yes, they might need more time before dying, but still, you will live every 1v1 in the game. The only way for you to die is if someone stuns you out of your shield, or if late game they've started building up wreckers just for you. That's the case on suspect everyone. Let me explain why some people don't run runic ammunition at all. Okay, it's not a bad card per se, but still, its value is going to diminish the more you go late into the game. Okay, it's not bad. You can get out of cauterize if you just hide behind your shield. The value of it is like this. You shoot 7 times every 1 second. That's 1190 damage per second. So 20% lifesteal if you were hitting people, not shields or anything else, is going to be 238 healing per second. If you're affected by cauterize 3, that's going to be 60 healing per second. Okay? That's it. So you better get out of cauterize if you want to run this card. And there is a good reason to run it only at 4. You see, Life Rip 1 is cheap and it makes this 30%. Percent is going to translate to, if you're affected by cauterize 3, you heal for 90 every second. If you buy Life Rip 3, the Diminishing Returns is gonna give you only 43% Life Rip, which is good still. It heals you for 128 every second. You know, that is more sustained than you already have with Suspect Everyone. So yes, buying Life Rip after you finish cauterize is still gonna be good late game on Vivian. She is good, just like Victor, if you're running this. You don't want to run it at 5, because you don't want to get the minimum advantage possible from Life Rip 1. 30% in the early game is going to be good. So yeah, I would buy Cauterize 1, Life Rip 1, and then build up Cauterize 3 before upgrading my Life Rip. I would do that. It's good enough early game to be doing that. You're simply just going to be doing way more than you should be possibly doing. And still, people run Vivian without lifesteal and still make her work. She is kind of really in a spot where if she is uncontested, she's going to win the game for her team.
Better spend these credits soon.
I just went back to this loadout and I want to say this. You're a squishy on this loadout. It's 2200 HP, so you better know how to use the shield, okay? It's easy, I know. Again, her skill ceiling is on the floor, maybe even below. But still, it's gonna take 6 shots of the Cassie bots to kill you if your shield is just up.
I'm not so frail. Watch the back! You'll pay for that.
Let's go ahead and see how many it takes if she shoots.
I'm not so frail.
So the shield took 4 shots. And then we took 3 shots to go to low HP and the first one killed us. So basically they have to shoot you 8 times before you die. And 8 times, well, on Androxus that's not gonna be, well, it's half a second times 8, it's gonna be 4 seconds. That's a lot. Cassie, she's gonna take even more, okay? She shoots every 0.75 seconds. That times 8 is 6 seconds. You're a tank, basically. You have the time, you need the enemy to take the time to kill of a tank to kill you. This is how good Suspect Everyone is. I just cannot believe that it took me this long to explain the simplest champion or even character in any video game. All Vivian does is hold one button, which is... Yes, she might dodge, but all she needs to do is just keep shooting. Have fun and enjoy Paladins.